What if the answers to humanity's greatest challenges, like the climate crisis, are hidden in plain sight, in nature? From self-healing building materials to airplanes borrowing secrets from the honeycomb, nature's innovations are shaping our modern world in ways we might never have imagined. Join us today as we explore the top 10 biomimicry examples of all time, where nature meets innovation. Coming in at number 10 is Speedo's LZR racer swimsuit. This swimsuit made a splash during the Olympic debut in 2008, where nearly every single medal and world record was broken wearing this suit. Sharkskin is covered with these types of scales called dermal denticles. It's kind of like sandpaper. These denticles distribute eddy formation and create a low pressure zone. This leading edge enables vortices in the shark to propel shark forward and reduce drag immensely. This now infamous and banned suit, designed by Speedo and NASA for the 2008 US Olympic swim team, won 98% of all Olympic gold medals. That's crazy. Additionally, these denticles are also covered with microscopic ridges, which make it incredibly hard for bacteria and other germs to cling to it. This makes it an ideal candidate for self-cleaning materials used in hospitals or schools. Number 9 on our list is Velcro and the burdock seeds. This is a story about a Swiss engineer turned a hiking annoyance into one of the most widely used fasteners in history. Oh, Velcro, what would we do without you? Did you know that this easy to plug and remove clamping mechanism was actually discovered and derived from nature? In 1941, a Swiss engineer named George de Menstrel was out hunting with his dog when he realized these small burrs from the burdock plant sticking to his dog's hair. On closer inspection, he realized these tiny hooks and loops can be made into clothing fasteners. This led to the discovery of Velcro, and this is a beautiful example of biomimicry and a leading example of innovation hiding in plain sight. Next on our list, we have Greenpod Labs and its founder, Deepak, who harnessed the language of plants to extend the life of fruits and vegetables and can potentially revolutionize the way we preserve food. The story begins with a profound respect for nature and a clear view of the problem at hand. Globally, about one third of food produced is lost before it reaches the consumer, and this waste is even worse in India. It amounts to about $12 billion each year. And despite India being the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables, 40% of it is lost before it reaches its consumer. Food waste isn't just a staggering loss of resources, it's a missed opportunity. What if we could communicate with the very food that's perishing and empower to last longer? This question led Deepak and his team at Greenpod Labs to develop a solution that is as effective as it is elegant. They created these sachets that release natural compounds at ambient temperature, activating the immune system of fruits and vegetables. This process, inspired by the way plants naturally defend themselves, can extend the shelf life of the produce by about 40 to 60%. It's a game changer, especially for those in the developing world without cold storage. Essentially, they're speaking nature's language. What Deepak has really illustrated is that it's all about falling in love with the problem. And this is one of my favorite examples of biomimicry in action. Personally, I love a fresh banana and avocado. This is nature-inspired architecture at a whole nother level. The BUGA Fibre Pavilion segments are built using two robots the University of Stuttgart developed fibre-winding robots, each placing fibrous filaments in between two rotating scaffolds. In this approach, it's 5 times lighter than conventional steel structure. Using a form of additive manufacturing, there's no need for a mold or a core, therefore no production waste or material offcuts. The fact that a single component of this pavilion can take the weight of 15 cars really speaks for itself. As for the inspiration behind this idea, the team looked towards load-bearing structures in biology, most of which came from the fibers such as cellulose, chitin, and collagen. Innovation par excellence. Well played to the University of Stuttgart. Coming in at number 6, we've got Jay Harmon, a biomimicry legend and founder of Pax Water Technologies. If we look to a pattern in nature long enough, we will see that nature is very much in deep love with spirals. How could it not be? These fractal patterns are found within whirlpools, tornadoes, certain seashells, and even plants like the Pax Lily. Jay Harmon and the scientists at Pax Water have developed active tank mixing technology and other applications like fans, which has reduced the energy required to similar outputs by about 30%. Based out of California and inspired by the Pax Lily and spiral flows, Pax Water Technology have created something truly unique. Innovating on active tank mixing technology, they have moved from this old, outdated way of mixing water with paddles to something that's as small as a light bulb and takes just as much energy to use. We take our hat off to Jay Harmon, a biomimicry enthusiast and nature-inspired innovator. Coming in at number 5, we have the lotus leaf and self-cleaning surfaces. The lotus effect inspired hydrophobic materials to repel dirt and water. Researchers at Adaptive Surface Technologies have created a surface coating that solves a problem as old as time. Studying a carnivorous plant called the pitcher plant with a unique technique to catching insects in its pouch, they discovered a way to put a liquid barrier between the substance of the container, which makes the substance fall right off without leaving any residue behind. Adaptive Surface Technologies, which was spun out of MIT, has resulted in innovations that can be applied to paint cans or even ship hulls. It's truly a unique innovation, and one inspired by the very unlikely pitcher plant. Coming in at number 4, we've got spider silk and a super strong material. Spintex Engineering, a leader in biomimicry engineering, is the holy grail of chemical science. Spider silk is a material lighter than hair and stronger than steel. And as humans, we're getting closer to replicating it. Spintex Engineering can spin fibers at room temperature just by pulling from a liquid protein gel and without any harsh chemicals. The fibers are high performance and also completely biodegradable. This has the ability to completely revolutionize the fashion and clothing industry. Spintex Engineering also won the Ray of Hope Prize, one of the leading awards for any biomimicry startup. The honeycomb structure is used in aerospace, packaging, and even urban planning. Honeycombs are nature's engineering masterpiece, and this hexagonal design is a marvel of efficiency and strength. Why? First, hexagons maximize volume with minimal material, and they resist buckling under pressure. That's why aeronautical engineers love it. Honeycombs have been studied for over 2,000 years, so it does beg the question, what more could we learn? Human honeycombs and bee honeycombs are slightly different. You see, humans' honeycombs are typically sharp edge, and bees and wasps have a rounded honeycomb. This subtle detail optimizes strength, reduces stress, and prevents fractures. Recently, a biologist studying bees collaborated with an engineer in a NASA-funded study. Together, they confirmed this insight, showing how rounded corners can create lighter, stiffer, and more resilient structures. Using these insights, they built a computer program that can help design better honeycomb structures for the aviation industry, aeronautical industry, and basically every other engineer. The lesson? Innovation thrives when biologists and engineers collaborate. By learning from bees and wasps, we can build smarter and more sustainable designs. After all, nature always gets it right. Coming in at number two, we've got self-healing concrete. Concrete makes the world go round, but as anything else in this world, it degrades over time. And with that amount of stuff that we use, it costs tens of billions of dollars to repair damaged concrete. And that's just every other year. What if we could have a concrete that heals itself as our own body does? This exact solution Hendrik Jonkers came up with when he found a rock-dwelling, limestone-producing Bacillus bacteria. This bacteria lies dormant inside concrete, and anytime a crack occurs, the material and the bacteria is exposed to moisture and air, it springs back into action and produces limestone. This bacteria has a lifespan of over 200 years and can save the world billions of dollars and a whole lot of time. With all that said, I think we need to be quite mindful about the designs that we do use with concrete. Here, I think we're playing with fire in the sense that concrete is an incredibly hardy material, and if it's self-healing, it's set to last longer. I think we could take a leaf out of the Romans book. Anything that is designed should always be beautiful to stand the test of time. Coming in at number one is our beloved biomimic, Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo da Vinci first applied biomimicry to the study of birds in the hope of enabling human flight. He very closely observed the anatomy and flight of birds and came up with numerous notes and sketches of his observation. He proposed the flying machine, known today as the aeroplane. His research later inspired the Wright brothers. These two American aviators invented, built, and flew the world's first successful motor-operated aeroplane. A simple but profound example of biomimicry in action. Leonardo da Vinci was both an engineer and had a deep curiosity for biology. And with that said, I'll leave you with a quote from da Vinci himself. The wisest and noblest teacher is nature itself. Those were our 10 favorite biomimicry examples of all time, though I have dived deeper into 50 plus examples, which you can find here on our website. If you're interested in learning what other biomimicry examples exist or how to apply it, check out learnbiomimicry.com to dive deeper into learning from nature and applying it to your designs. Nature holds the answers to questions we've yet learned how to ask. And if you are curious to learn more, check out learnbiomimicry.com to continue your learning journey.